Jamie, I don't believe it. You've actually done it. You've opened the Westside Community Legal Centre.
Believe it, Max. I finally cracked.
That's great. I mean, how? Why? What happened?
Well, let's just say God stepped in and he's on my side.
Oh, that's great. Listen, I've got to go to work, but there's a couple of things I wanted to talk to you about before I do.
Yeah?
Come on, Jamie.
Jamie, this is important.
Oh, Jamie.
Time to go. Big day tomorrow.
Come on, Jamie.
Well, don't let me stop you.
Huh? Hey, everyone, thanks very much for everything. But just remember, if you've got any legal problems from now on, your new legal officer is in. Thunder, rain, lightning, let it rip. And if the worst happens and you get hit by a big hailstone, then I promise that I'll represent you in your compo claim.
Jamie.
And I won't charge you either. I mean, if it wasn't for you giving me that gentle push, then I'd still be wandering around moping and feeling sorry for myself, wondering what to do with my life.
You happy about it?
Happy? You bet I'm happy. And the people of Westside need help, and I'm going to be there to give it to them.
The Mother Teresa of Westside.
Come on. Don't make fun of me. I mean, it's not a crime to want to feel good about yourself, you know?
Oh, no, of course not. I can't think of a better man for the job.
Really? Thank you.
Jamie, about kissing you before, I hope you don't think that means anything, that it's...
What?
Not...
You know what it meant? It was that you and I are friends. And when good things happen, we're happy for each other, right?
Right.
And then I don't think we have a problem in the world.
Not a one.
Yeah.
Run for it.
Okay.
Julia, however bad things are, there's got to be a better answer than this.
Is there? I don't know one.
Of course there is. But I don't know what's going on, and I can't help until I do.
You're better off for everyone if you'd let me finish the job.
Did you kill Gary Foster? Well, then where'd you get the gun? Look, I'm going to get to the bottom of this, and if you're not going to help me, I'll find out for myself. Where's Foster's file? Where is it? You've hidden it. You destroyed it.
No, I...
Look, I need to know, Julia. No matter how painful it is for you, you've got to tell me.
Then what? Once you've unpicked all the wounds, are you really prepared to face up to what you see?
I think so.
Then face up to this. Amy's sickness has returned. Worse than ever. Sam, she's at the point of no return.
Chance of finding Stephen Richardson.
Night's when it's gonna be.
Sarge, do you really think he's still in Westside?
You really can't afford to think otherwise. You better throw this in the bin. Sitting here yakking's not gonna find anyone.
Sarge.
If we're lucky, it'll stay that way.
Warning or no warning, I just can't believe that Amy's losing her mind.
It's a fact. Take it or leave it.
I find you sitting here with a gun to your head, and the only explanation you can give me is that Amy's nuts. Why should I believe a word of it?
You'd better, for all our sakes.
Then what's the connection?
You'll see.
What is it?
It's a link that binds me, Amy, and Gary Foster. And always will, even now that he's dead. And it's a link that only Amy can help explain.
Morning.
G'day.
Hey, nice suit.
Well, it's not too dressy.
No. It's a bit flash, maybe, but that's not necessarily a bad thing.
Yeah, well, I don't want people to think I'm not taking the job seriously, that's all.
I don't think there's any danger about James. Let me give you a hand.
Ta. Because, you know, it's really important to me that people realise that I'm there to help. I'm not just another faceless bureaucrat.
With an attitude like that, James, you'll be turning them away.
Yeah, well, as long as people know they can trust me, that's all. Oh, look at that old guy. He's probably been there all night. Look, I'm going to take him down the legal centre and see if he wants a cup of coffee. Hey, matey, you want a cup of coffee? Hey! What's his problem?
James, I don't think we can just change his life with a cup of coffee.
I suppose you're right, but I don't like seeing anybody like that.
No, me either. Maybe he'll find his own way to make some changes to his life. Now, come on. Remember, you're a legal person, not a social worker.
You're right, you know. I guess I've been overcome with this sudden desire to change the world.
Good, then don't lose it. Let's go.
You're looking tired. You all right?
Yeah. Let's face it, being up half the night looking for Steve at Richardson wouldn't make anybody feel on top of the world.
Hey, don't tell me he's on the loose again.
I'm not telling you anything. I can't comment on police business, Ern, you know that.
Still, if he's free in West Side.
Ernie, I'm here for breakfast, not an interrogation, so you mind?
Yeah, of course. Go on through. You'll never guess what George just told me.
Sorry, we don't have the fruit platter this morning.
Thanks.
Hi, Tom.
Hi.
How are you?
Good. Hi. Do you mind if I join you? If you want to.
I don't get it. After what happened with Jason, I thought she'd be the last person Toni would want to eat with.
CJ, you know how she felt last time we tried to interview?
I'm not going to say anything, honest. I just think it's weird.
Well, I've been thinking about our talk. And although I don't really agree with all your ideas, I just wanted to make sure that you know there's no hard feelings about Jason and everything. Never occurred to me that there would be. Well, maybe we could be friends. Well, sure. Sam, what are you doing here?
I've been waiting for you.
Oh. You look like you've been up all night.
I have.
What's happened?
Something I wanted to ask you. You coming here?
What's going on? We've been talking. And now it's time we did some more.
Sorry about the mess. Didn't realize it's such a dump.
No worries. We'll soon have it fixed up. What do you think? Bit down on the left?
No, that's fine.
Ah, first customer. Oh, Max.
Hey, Jamie.
Hi, Rev. Max.
Had a couple of minutes to spare, so I thought I'd come around and give you a hand, mate.
Oh, great.
Well, you can do more than give us a hand, Max. You can take over. I've got to go. I'll see you later. Best of luck.
Thanks, Bob.
Bye. See you, Rev.
Bye. Well, what do you think, Max? Should I put out the BRWs?
BRWs?
Yeah. Business Review Weeklies. I think I will. Now, because if I want people to see me as accessible, then I have to make sure that the office reflects my personality. In fact, I've got to create a total environment, like those medical centres. Yeah. Nothing too flash. It's a matter of creating the right ambience. What do you think of Vivaldi?
Well, I don't know, mate. I don't really know that much about him, eh?
You're right. Gilbert and Sullivan's much better. Yep. Can't wait, Max. They're going to flock in. Any minute now.
Problem. A psychological disorder. It was something that couldn't be cured in a few sessions. Well, why don't you tell Sam what the disorder was, Mother? I'm sure he'd be very interested. I don't think it's all that relevant. Not right now. I was interested in him as a patient, but there was more than that. His particular disorder was something I'd been researching for quite some time, and with his permission, I was going to use him as the basis of a series of articles for a medical journal. So what do you say?
Me in a magazine. Sure, why not? Maybe like some photos to go with it. You know, like a centerfold? Reckon your doctor mates would like that?
I don't know.
But you would, wouldn't you?
As is normal in a long-term patient-therapist relationship, as he began to trust me, he began to relax with me and to open up more freely. He didn't exactly develop dependence in the clinical sense, but I think it's fair to say he started to rely emotionally on our sessions.
And what about you, Mother? Aren't you going to tell Sam how you felt, emotionally speaking?
Well, he was my patient. I felt toward him like I do all my patients.
Oh, come on, Mum, you can do better than that.
Don't, Amy, please.
What are you getting at?
Look, my mother is very good at leaving out important bits of information. It's just as well I'm good at putting them back in. The fact is, Gary Foster wasn't just a patient of my mother's, he was also her lover.
Any tick of the clock, it's going to be an absolute stampede, I know it.
Well, then I'd better get out of here before I get trampled, eh, mate? Best of luck, Jamie. Take care. I'll see you later, mate.
Thanks, mate. Yep. Community Legal Centre. Can I help you? Yes, I'm glad you called. Hello, Community Legal Centre. How can I help you? Trouble with the landlord? Not a problem. I'll have it fixed before you know it. Hello, Community Legal Centre. How can I help you? Who? No, I'm sorry. You've got the wrong number. Yes, I'm quite sure. I am definitely not the vet. Well, even if that was the number you were given, I'm not qualified to treat mange. Yes, I'm absolutely sure. Goodbye. Any tick of the clock.
Guys always find me so attractive.
I guess. It becomes a problem when you open your eyes to see what you've attracted. And next time I'll do that long before I move in with the guy.
Sounds serious. What happened?
It's not really worth talking about.
Was it that bad?
No, it's just not worth talking about. All right. Do you want another drink? If you like. CJ, can I have 2 more orange juices, thanks?
Sure. Hey, how come you're being so pally after what she did to you?
She's a free spirit, that's all. I didn't own Jason.
You just sort of shared a bit of emotional space with him, right?
So I don't see why I shouldn't like her. Actually, I think we've got a lot in common.
Yeah? Like what?
Well, it's hard to say. She's got this air of mystery about her.
Whatever turns you on.
She's special, CJ. It's only hope that some of it will rub off onto me.
You don't understand. It wasn't like that.
Liar.
I'm not. All right, I admit I was attracted to Gary, but it was just a case of transference. It happens to most psychiatrists.
What you're saying is that Amy's making this up.
No, not exactly, but...
What's not exactly?
Look, is that the best you can do? All right, yes, I admit it. We did have an affair. I'm not proud of it, but it wasn't a crime.
Well, what happened afterwards was...
Well, I still don't see the connection between Amy and Gary Foster.
Go on, Mother. Don't stop now.
Amy often came to see me at the office. And as a result, it was inevitable that she would sometimes get to know some of my patients, at least on a superficial level. I'd just gone out of my office for a moment. Amy dropped by, and Gary started flirting with her immediately.
Hi.
You're Julia's daughter, aren't you?
Yeah.
I'm Gary.
Hi.
Just got out of school, eh? Yeah, me too. Only I had to break out of mine.
When I came back, it was patently obvious that Amy was responding. I'm busy now, Amy. I think you should leave.
I only came to see you, Mum.
Not now, Amy. I'll call you at home.
See you around, Amy.
Bye.
She was still a child. She was unaware of what he was doing. And for her own good, I tried to protect her.
For my own good? My welfare never entered your head.
It did.
You're amazing. You know, you can't even be honest with yourself.
What do you want from me, Amy?
The truth! Protecting me was the last thing on your mind, Mother. The only reason you wanted to keep me away from Gary was that you were jealous of the fact that he fancied me more than he fancied you.
No, it wasn't like...
It's the kind of mother you were.
Interrupting, am I?
No, not a bit. But if you'd been here earlier, boy, what a rush. I mean, I knew I'd be busy, but I thought I'd have at least some free time. But it's been non-stop since 9 o'clock.
That's what I figured. I thought you wouldn't have time to go out and get lunch, and you might appreciate me bringing something.
It's great.
Do you have a client with a drinking problem?
No. Yes. No.
Well, that's always your answer, isn't it? Get out and pretend the problem never existed. I'm not going to let you do it. Not this time.
You can't do that to me. There's no law that says I have to stay. All right. But I'm not so sure you want to hear it. You'll never be able to look at Amy in the same way ever again. Stay away from Amy. From now on, I don't want you anywhere near her.
I tried my best, Amy. You must know that. Well, you really deserve points for imagination, you know. Why don't you tell Sam what you never told me?
What do you mean?
Tell him what you were treating Gary for.
That's confidential.
Oh, he's dead, Mum. Tell him.
Gary was... He had a history of... offences relating to children.
It's amazing, isn't it? Little details a mother can leave out.
So, tell me about your clients. Any interesting cases?
Lots, but I can't tell you about them. They're confidential.
Oh, you don't have to name names, just the juicy bits.
It'd be unprofessional.
This is me, your flatmate, your friend. We're supposed to share things.
Penny.
Unless there's nothing to share.
What do you mean?
How many clients have you actually had?
Oh, don't know. Who's counting?
I am. More than a dozen or less?
A few less.
How many?
12.
Oh, Jamie, you poor thing. You haven't even had one client.
Nope, not a one. I mean, I was so busy getting the place opened up that I forgot one tiny detail. Nobody knows where I am.
Well, we're going to have to find a way of telling them.
But how?
Easy. You leave it to me. You might be the one with the brains, but I'm the one with the ideas. Attention, everyone! I'm on a rescue mission. For you, and for you, and for you.
What's all this about, Penny?
We've got to make posters to promote an open house at the community legal centre.
What for?
For Jamie. He's sitting there talking to himself and no one else. You, and for you too.
Understand if you don't want to do it. No one expects you to be involved.
Are you kidding? The guy needs all the help he could get.
Do you want to help?
It's a bit cute for my digestion, but why not?
It's all right with you. I'll go and round up some street kids and other potentials and see you back there.
Sure, Bob. We'll see you back there.
I can't think of what to write.
It hasn't got to be art, CJ.
Yeah, but it's got to be right. Oh, no. Free food and the address.
Brilliant. CJ, do it quickly. How you going?
Nice. Right. Gary started stalking me. That's the only way I can describe it.
Hi. You walking my way?
I don't know.
Why don't I carry a bag for you? Why you decide? Well, have you decided yet? Come on. Come on.
How was I supposed to react? Huh? I was 15. I didn't know a thing about men. He must have thought I was an absolute gift. A gift that you handed to him. I did not. I told him to stay away. What more could I do? You could have warned me. You could have acted like a mother. But I know now that was expecting a bit much.
What are you doing here? You look like you're getting ready for a party. Why are you doing
it? Fast, isn't he?
We're throwing an open house for the legal centre and it's happening here in about 15 minutes.
What? Here?
Yeah, so why didn't you give us a hand and put these into some bowls?
Yeah, but what if a client comes in and needs help?
One, you haven't had a client all day, and two, all your potential clients are going to be here anyway.
Yeah, but...
Go with the flow, James. You'll live longer.
All right.
Hi, Bob.
Getting organised?
Yeah, well, it looks like it.
Good, because you've got about 10 minutes. Now, there'll be a whole herd of people come charging in here. I'm not sure, James, but think big. It's safer that way.
Come on, Jamie, get a move on.
You don't have the right to examine every detail of my life.
And you don't have the right to be in possession of a pistol. And I can't guarantee I won't act on it.
Why are you taking her side? And you're pretending to be so innocent when you knew you were supposed to stay away from my patients.
How else was I ever supposed to see you, huh? I mean, you were always so busy. It was the only chance I got to do more than say hello.
Find your own spot, why don't you? What's the matter with you? Cat got your tongue? All right, suit yourself. If you want to watch, I can't stop you. Long as you understand, watching's all you're gonna do.
Excuse me, please. Guys. Ladies. I think it's about time I made my speech.
What speech?
Well, you know, the one about the legal centre and how it can help everyone.
I don't know, James. It might be best to just let them get on with the party. The important thing is that they know you're here.
Yeah, well, I think they need to know more than that. Excuse me. Hang on, I'm sorry. The music will be back on in 5 minutes. Right, my name's James Newman, and I'd like to welcome you one and all to the Westside Community Legal Centre. I hope that you find this centre to be a part of your community and a refuge from whatever storms may be occurring in your lives. I can offer you good legal advice, and not only that, I can offer you a home.
Going on forever. How can we stop him?
I don't know, we can wrap a book around his neck and drag him off.
In short, front doors, it's going to be like walking into the home of your own family.
Family.
He's obviously never seen any of their relatives.
Well, at least the home of a friend. Do you think they got the message?
Of course they have.
Just because you're living on the street don't mean to say you don't need to have manners. It ain't polite to stare at somebody when they're having a feed. All right, if you're not gonna go away, you might as well come in and sit here where it's a bit warmer. You take this on. I'm gonna throw it out anyway. Here. Get your spoon. Here. When you're finished, you got to go away, because if there's one thing I value, it's me privacy. You know, there's an art to living on the street, and I don't like your chances. I'm a 30-year veteran of this sort of life, and I've seen a lot of people like you fall away and die. More than you've had hot dinners, I'd say. Although, by the look of you, you haven't had too many of them recently. It's not the clothes you're wearing. It's nothing like that. It's a look you blokes get about you when you're just about to fail and drop off the twig. You know how I know that? Well, I'll tell you. It's the aura. And mate, you've got the aura of death about you.
Well,
If I'd had any sense at all, I would have gone straight home, packed my bags, and got out of your life forever. But I didn't. I waited in the corridor for you to finish work. I wanted to explain to you what really happened. And finally, when you didn't come out, I plucked up the courage to go in. Amy, I told you to go home.
What are you doing?
It's not what you think, honestly.
Oh, how could you?
Well, one thing. I learned what good meant.
Buddy for it. They all laugh at me. I think I'm an idiot.
No, they don't.
Hey, I'm so busy trying to make the place look right, I forgot I'm here to help.
Maybe you did try a bit too hard, but things will pick up tomorrow.
Well, you think they'll come back?
Of course they will, especially if you loosen up just a little bit.
Yeah. I get the message.
So stop punishing yourself.
I've had enough of this. Do you want to go?
Sure.
You don't have to.
No, I want to. Let's go.
Take you down the pub.
Hi.
Hi. Isn't this a bit out of control?
Yep, it's totally out of control. I think I'd better do something about it. Okay, everyone. Party's over. Come on. It's time to go. That's it. Everybody, out we go. And just because something's not nailed down, it doesn't mean it's yours.
Come on, everyone.
Let's go.
Bob says out, he means it. On the double. Come on. Out you go. Come on.
After that night, I ended the affair with Gary. I told him I never wanted to see him again.
Hmm. And what was the result? It enraged him. And he took it out on me.
Tom!
Oh, don't, I won't tell you. I'll do anything.
You're gonna do everything. And your mother's gonna be sorry for the way she treated me. Very sorry.
He kept me there for the longest 3 months of my life. And when he finally let me out, I wanted to tell the police, of course. I wanted to tell the world what that animal had done to me. But you know what my loving mother did? She had me committed.
You were sick. You needed help.
Not that kind. All you wanted to do was to shut me up. Keep me out of the way until the whole thing blew over. You see, if the police had found out, she would have been struck off.
Amy, I'm so sorry.
Well, it's okay. I survived, you know? I survived by telling myself that one day I would get my revenge on Gary Foster. Well, it was a very long wait. And then they brought Stephen Richardson into the hospital.
You used Stephen.
He's the ultimate killing machine. Who better to settle the score?
You should have been there. I've never seen so many wall-to-wall bums.
Yeah? But will it bring in the customers?
Oh, who knows? It might.
Hey, I hear the open house was a great success.
Canada, look, the guy doesn't need to be patronised.
What I need is a drink. And then if it's okay with all of you, I don't want to hear anyone mention the words open house ever again.
How about on the...
You can see that, can't you?
I was wrong, Amy.
No, Sam, it wasn't. He took my innocence. He destroyed my life. I had to.
Like that?
Yes, like that. I'm proud of what I did. And I'm proud of the way I planned it.
I wrote to him in jail telling him that I wanted him. And he was so vain and so stupid that he believed it. So I arranged to meet him at the warehouse where I had Stephen waiting to kill him. But it didn't quite work out like that.
Stephen didn't kill him?
Stephen Richardson, mass murderer, repented at the last minute. The gun. And I thought good and hard about what he had done to me, and I pulled the trigger.
Oh, no, Amy.
I would do it again, Sam. He deserved to die. There, Sam. You got what you wanted. Now I'm leaving. And you can't stop me. Well, there it is. That's the whole story.
You shouldn't have told me.
You shouldn't have asked. But I am glad that you did, Sam. I think that you deserve the truth after everything you've been through.
Too boring for you.
Toni, you have to stop apologizing for yourself.
You're so cool about everything.
Yeah, I've got a front, big deal. You've got so much going for you.
Like what? You know, you have real friends. They don't care what sort of an attitude you're projecting. And neither should you. Anyway, I'm sick of talking. It's boring. Do you like it?
I love it. It's really pretty.
It's yours.
I can't take that.
Yes, you can. I've got lots. Go on, have it. I want you to.
Oh, okay, if you're sure. Wow. It must be worth a fortune.
It's worth a cup of coffee.
No problem.
I've loved you since you were 12 years old. And hard I try, I just can't push it aside.
I would understand if you did.
I just wish you could have trusted me. There could have been a way to change what's happened.
I know. I know. I wasn't feeling very trusting of anyone.
I know. Who else knows about this?
Apart from my mother. Just Stephen. He would say he saw it.
Then we're gonna have to find him quickly. And make sure he never tells anyone.
Beginning to feel sorry for him now. No tea or sympathy required next. Time to dust down the brain cells, though, for a brand new week of blockbusters.